Alright, kicking off the week at Skyline. Didn't notice it when I was climbing, but there must be a fire somewhere. It's kind of smoky. Lungs are burning a little bit. But good to be back with my homie Nando.
What's up?
We're getting back on the program, right?
Have to.
The Skyline 6 a.m. club.
Let's do it.
I think daylight savings is in a month, right?
I think so.
We'll have to do that or start riding with lights at night.
Yeah.
Dude, this shit is gonna be dry.
I know. It is. Can't wait.
So let's do, you want to do Troy Lee and then Trencherous?
I'm done. Yeah.
Yeah. Trench Bomb. That's the trail where chicks get black eyes. This trail is so slippery. Oh! I want to know why there's a folding chair right here. I'm trapped. Here we go. Dude, I like didn't even really fall. I just tipped over. You know how we came down that chute?
Yeah.
Did you see that turn to the right?
Yeah, I did. I almost took it. I'm hiking.
Bypass?
Yeah. And I think it connects back
up. Dude, those plants stink.
Yeah, you do. Heading all the way down.
Dude. Yeah, I was okay. I went down that okay. But I slid here and I lost my balance and just went boop and tipped over. Fucking kook. Thank you. Thai restaurant, and he gets the thing that's closest to fried chicken.
Heck yeah, baby. look how orange it is.
Orange chicken. That's like fried chicken with orange Kool-Aid.
And it, look, don't forget, look at this.
All right, it's Wednesday. Chase and I are, we are in the desert.
Beautiful Palmdale.
Lovely Palmdale. We're headed to LA County Raceway. Our buddy Rob Healy, formerly of N Style fame, has ridden the track. And I think there's only gonna be like 20 people here today, so should be a good time. Meeting Scrub Daddy here also. It's kind of funny, the one thing about LA County is it's really fast.
Right.
Like fourth gear, fifth gear, and the jumps are really big, and I always suck here the first time I ride, but Scrubby is like really fast here.
Yeah, because he's a jumper.
Yeah, so today might be the one day that he gets to beat me, but we'll see.
Is he bringing the 450 or 282 stroke?
He says he's bringing his 450 Yamaha. It'll be the first time he's ridden it, so I hope he does. I don't think he'd bring the two stroke because I think it's hard to do the jumps on two stroke.
Okay, yeah.
I don't know. So, there's a restaurant we like to eat at on the way home called Charlie Brown Farms. It's kind of like the craziest store I've ever been to. They have like a restaurant with like awesome tri-tip sandwiches and stuff, and good frozen custard ice cream. Have you had that yet?
No. What's okay. That big old like goose egg or something? The dinosaur?
Oh no, they sell ostrich eggs.
Yeah.
But so they have everything at this store, including like 10-foot tall dinosaur statues. There's a room full of really creepy, ugly dolls. And we'll show you that. We're gonna go on a little adventure there afterwards. Okay. So Hot Hoppa is here. What? My birthday was like 2 weeks ago.
I know, but I haven't seen you.
You don't have to give me a birthday present.
You
Your
go.
Friendship is enough, buddy.
You should keep that rolling.
Thank you. Oh God, we'll have to see what it is.
Oh, is that the new 10?
What? Yeah, this is the new 10. GoPro 10. Okay, we'll open this on camera in a little bit. Got our homie Umberto Baca, the world's triggest sprinter.
I raced 1,000 and 600s.
Doing like 180.
Mr. Nappy.
Yeah.
What's up, Mr. Nappy?
Dang, man, when I was looking, I'm like,
look at this. Brand new. 22. YZ450. Wait a second. What is this?
Man, I don't know what, it won't stay.
Huh?
It
won't stick?
No.
If you had backyard designs, it'd stick.
Well, hey, I didn't want to hit y'all up.
Oh, whoa, what is this?
What, this side too?
Dude. Dude, seriously.
Yeah, it's pretty jacked up.
Who put these on? Stevie?
Me?
Stevie Wonder?
Hey, it won't stick. Have they always been this thin?
I don't know, dude, but those might fly off today.
Yeah,
you're
going
that
so
fast,
man.
Right?
Yeah. Especially on this track.
Yeah. What is this logo, dude?
What logo?
The Zoid.
Yeah,
what is this part?
I don't know what that is. That's.
And what is this?
That is a GoPro.
You used to put a GoPro on the bottom of your camera?
Yep.
You know, this whole thing looks like something from Star Wars, like a...
See, I had to be different. My nephew made that, so I was like, all right, cool, man.
But what is this?
What?
Not, dude.
Yeah, I know. I don't know what's going on.
We're gonna get you the proper graphics, all right?
Because
we're teammates, right?
Yes.
See, look at this. Look at how good this bike looks. This is backyard.
Yeah, but guess what? I just found out that this guy. A multi-millionaire.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, I didn't
know
that.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
I don't know about that.
Oh, Chase unloaded my bike for me. Today's promoter, Rob Healy.
Hello. Thank you. Thank you. I may say thank you.
Yeah.
Thursday. So, how are you, Don Maeda?
I'm good.
Perfect.
I'm good. Who else is coming?
Yeah, this is the LACR Weekly and Style Powerlift Ride. We have them every Wednesday from 9 to 1.
And everyone's welcome.
Everyone's welcome. Today's
speaking
the main
of power,
track.
Speaking of powerlift,
yeah.
Let's come this way.
Okay.
I've got three dead powerlifts.
Okay, good. I gotta get them all fixed.
There they are. And they have the wrong logos. Hmm? They have the wrong logos. They say TWMX on them.
No, I'll redo those. I'll redo them all. Okay. Oh, they have bushes. Okay. Alright. Cool.
Alright. So, what number are you running on your bike these days? Four?
Four.
N1?
No, no N1.
What was
N1,
the story behind N1?
N1 was, I was number 52, and I was a pro, and I called Shirley Shore of AME, Jerry Shore's wife, his family that had AME, American Motocross mm-hmm. Enterprises, and I wanted a letter and a one-digit number, and I thought, I want to be an N. Well, when I called Shirley, she said, I go, what's available? She goes, I go, how about N4? She says, no, that's taken. Well, is there anything else? The only thing that's available is N1. And I said, well, that's O'Mara's number. Well, she says, yeah, but he's on the Nationals now. He don't care about it. So you take it. I thought, oh, boy. So I'm going to be like a Johnny O'Mara wannabe. So that's how I became N1.
Okay. And is that where N-Style came from?
No. Yeah. N-Style just came from, actually, the name N-Style really came from Dave Osterman.
Oh. Dave. Oh, like N-Style?
Yeah, he just, and he had the idea just the N rather than I-N to shorten it up. For the look and logo and the purpose, you know, the direction of that, and then I was the concept of an arrow, because I had drafting in high school, and I used to try to make really good arrows in drafting, and then when I would scribble, like on the phone when you're talking to somebody, you're kind of, you got nervous energy, I would try to make the perfect arrow, so that a guy named Michael Gibson, who had actually won an Academy Award for a logo in a movie, I had become friends with Racing Golden State one year, and I told him I had this idea and this name for numbers, and I said, I'm gonna call it Ent Style, and put an arrow in it. You know, the letter N, the word style, put an arrow in it. He designed the logo and an arrow, and that's what it is still today.
And Ent Style 2.0.
2.0.
Yeah, okay. Show me some lines today.
What's that?
You gonna show me some lines today?
Oh, of course. In fact, I'm gonna have to pull you.
500 mph.
You know, you're still a young whippersnapper by my standards, so I'm gonna have to make sure I pull you over the big jumps there.
Well, yeah, I'm not used to going 90 miles an hour to clear a triple.
And you know, speaking of numbers, I know why you're 48. You used to be 10.
Yeah.
Okay, and I have a helmet that you gave me that's got 10 on it.
Yep.
And you gave it to me as your arch rival at the time, you said.
Yeah.
And you're 4'8" because Ross was number 8.
Yep.
And it's 4'8", so 4 Ross.
Yep. You got it.
Yep.
Look at this. Look at this patch. Is that because...
That was because
you fell over...
My Colorado trip.
And ripped a hole in your leg with a foot peg?
Yeah.
Hi, Hapa, give me some of this! Woo!
They're brand new. So uh-huh.
You know, back in the day, I tore the knee of my Sears Tough Skin corduroys.
And my mom
put a patch on it. It was like, you know, the hand like this. And it was like stars and stripes in it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I had that patch on my brown tough skin corduroys.
You should have kept those. It'd probably be cool again right now.
Back when I was a kid and I had these corduroys, though, I was so fat and my thighs would rub together that the corduroy ribs would be gone on the thighs of my pants. It was really embarrassing. So what? You think there's gonna be like 20 people here today? What's the limit on a rental? 20 or is it 30?
It's supposed to be 20.
20. I think there's more than 20. This today is quite profitable for Rob Healy.
Yep.
You know, overcharging his renters and making his house payment. Are you ready for this?
I'll stay ready.
This is a vlog first. Uh-huh. You got me today. I'm scared of this track, dude. Why you gotta hit all the jumps going 70 miles an hour?
I know. Third gear pin.
Yeah, so I'm gonna put my GoPro on you. We're gonna have a scrub.
Even though, look, the red battery's about to be dead.
Yeah, well, I'm gonna put a new battery on. Uh-huh. Is there a battery meter on the front?
Yeah, it's red. It's about to be dead.
Alright, here we go. Let's go, baby. GoPro time. I feel like Dylan Ferrandez with the red background. The champ is here. Oh, I keep looking for a kickstart. Oh, what a mess. Papa bought me a birthday present against my better judgment.
Do it.
Oh my
god. Oh, there's six.
I thought you're supposed to wear socks, no?
Dude, optional.
I don't know about the buttons, dude.
Oh yeah.
Wait, I think they're big.
Yeah, nice. Dude. Perfect.
This is not the pinnacle of comfort. Dude, look at that!
Oh, that
these
looks
things
amazing.
Are goofy.
Hold on.
Right, see, even there he's laughing. Right?
You're on Crocs now, dude.
No Crocs, dude. I'm wearing them to humor Hoppa because they're a birthday gift.
Let me see. Let me at least get a good.
Motorcycle parking. We got motorcycles.
Yeah, but.
The motorcycle there.
Why is your bike always leaning over so much?
Because that's the road, bro.
Motorcycles there. Where are you parking motorcycles?
This is the best bike ever.
So what do you think of Yamaha on day one?
Too good.
It's good, huh?
Yep.
Where do you ride mine? You'll be crying.
Why? The suspension?
Yeah.
Yeah, the suspension feels ugly already.
Ugly?
The front end is like this.
Yeah.
Maybe I got something. Ooh,
promised land.
Wait, what? Where's Umberto? No, Umberto.
It's training food here. You gonna get a fried Oreo?
What is that?
Hey, a deep fried Oreo cookie.
I'm trying to get a, what we getting, burgers?
The burgers are actually, the tri-tip's good.
The burgers ain't no good.
They got a little purse of Scrub Daddy. Okay, board games.
socks.
See? That's why the table like this, so if they weigh 400 pounds, it's all good.
You sitting down already? You're not looking around? It's gonna take like a half hour for our food. These fools are slow. Candy, monster heads. Boxing nun.
Picking the sky blue rose, huh?
So I'm coming to get something in particular. Got one last time and it provided a ton of laughs. Oh, should we get some office decor? Maybe this one for Pat Foster. Oh, they got Yuki. Okay, where's that? Oh no, they sell out? Oh. They not have snakes? Dude, they must have sold out.
You motherfucker.
Hey, for Sunday.
What's that?
You need anything if you go Sunday?
What do you mean?
Do I need anything? You need anything?
Oh. No. Why? Yeah.
Hey, you want to trade, huh?
What?
What'd you get? Barbecue sandwich?
Yo.
You probably want to trade for this, huh?
That's too much.
Are you enticed by the chicken?
I want to see you eat that. And just beans?
We probably could have shared one, huh?
Yeah.
Easily. A little bit. Right, take it home, eat it for Mark tomorrow.
Yeah.
So you're finally here, Seth. It's taken a little while.
Finally made it.
Schedule conflicts, cross-country moves.
Yep, the move is a big holdup.
Yeah. So have you seen the show before? You know what it's about?
Seen bits and pieces.
Yeah.
I was actually watching a little bit of Shane's yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
I saw part of Peanuts. I haven't watched the whole thing, though. No.
Yeah. Peanuts was good.
Yeah, I like Peanuts. He's a good guy. No, I've seen clips here and there, but... I didn't watch the whole thing. My ADD kicks in a little bit.
Yeah, it's super casual.
Yeah.
3 10-minute segments.
Yeah.
You're going to have to sing at some point, though. You know that, right?
Ooh. I don't know. I wish I could sing.
Dude, you've come a long way since the very first time I interviewed you.
We made it a little
far. Remember you said like one word? Having fun out here, Jay? Yup. Do you remember we even put in it, the post said, Ryan Surratt is a man of few words.
I think I didn't remember that one.
Oh, Arnold. Ending the week at Paris. Homie Umberto.
Morning.
Oh, so you're riding the Husky today, not the gas.
Yes.
That means you're going to get over the back jump easier today?
No.
What do you mean no?
It scares me.
No, no.
Let's go
we'll
back
do
to
it
LACR.
Together. We'll do
I
it
like
together.
LACR.
So we got the Yamaha YZ250 intro today. I think it's us and Kiefer.
So do you consider, are you one of the guys like, oh, he's sold out? Absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely.
Shit.
See, I like bubblegum look.
Why is it called that?
Ask
Casey if he likes MGK.
If what?
If he likes MGK.
Machine Gun Kelly?
If you like Machine Gun Kelly, unfollow me.
on Instagram at Air D 617.
Is RV here? He's not coming, is he? RV's coming?
RV's coming. Oh. He said he's going to show you a thing or two.
Oh, fuck that. He's washed up. Whoa. Mathis is riding thing?
Yeah, automatically.
Yeah,
he's the new test rider for us.
Is this for A-Race Log?
Are you riding today?
Yeah, that's what I do. I ride.
You ride.
I'm a racer.
Blue crew.
Blue crew needs me.
Listen to that scrub guy just talk. I just documenting him flapping his lips, you know. So we're joined today by some mountain bike elite. Okay, so I was confused for a long time.
What?
Say Kaylee Skelton.
Kaylee Skelton.
But your Instagram was like Kaylee Skelton.
Saley Kelton.
Saley.
People think my name is Saley all the time.
They'll come up to me
at the races. They're like, "What's up, Saley?" And I'm like, "What's up?" But I just play it off.
Okay, so how do you define yourself? Previous to the last 2 years, are you a motocrosser, a photographer, a surfer, a mountain biker?
A little bit of everything.
Well, you do now, all of it, right?
For a career, I race mountain bikes professionally. Downhill
mountain
bikes.
And that career kind of just happened by surprise?
Sort of. My boyfriend, Nicholas Nesteroff, is an elite professional downhill mountain biker.
Yeah.
And he kind of kicked it off for me. He saw my potential because I used to ride mountain bikes just for fitness and fun. Because I had the adrenaline side from dirt bikes. And then from there, he saw and he just wanted me to sign up for a race for fun. And it ended up being Crafts and Cranks and Big Bear. And I won $2,000 my first race. So.
Okay, so your very first downhill race, you entered the pro class.
Yeah, I don't really know how that happened. We kind of like...
Did your boyfriend just say you're racing pro?
So we kind of like swung it. I don't know how... It was more of like the people at the booth not paying attention and we kind of just wrote it down and it worked out. But then the result backed it. So then I was able to bypass everything and just stay in the pro class from the start. So that worked out.
So there was no beginner class for you?
No. Didn't go through Cat 3, 2, or 1. Just
so,
straight to the point.
Right after that, is that when you got picked up by KHS?
A little after. I was on like a frame deal. And then year after, it turned into like a full contract.
Mm-hmm.
Now we're racing World Cups and traveling.
And you just won the national championship.
I did, yeah. And then I hold the national title for the U.S. in the elite women's group.
That is awesome.
So I got the American sleeve on the left arm. Yeah. You know, we're repping. And it feels good.
So is it kind of funny how that all happened? Like, I mean, you used to cross train on a mountain bike, right?
Yeah, I used to cross train for moto just for fun. My original plan, I grew up surfing and in the ocean. I wanted to be a surf photographer, a surfer mag. I was fortunate enough and lucky to travel with them for a couple years to different places to shoot for different projects.
Mm-hmm.
But that's how it started. I traveled for a year with KHS, with Nick, just shooting the races. I shot for KHS and then would bring my bike and ride a couple of times. And then from there, I just liked it a lot, so I want to try it out, and yeah, now we're here.
Okay, so what did it feel like winning the national championship? What did it feel like when you won? I mean, you went from, you were winning races beforehand, but I mean, national title.
It felt really good. I knew it was possible. I knew I had the potential to do it, but it was just a special one because I love my home. I'm really proud of this place, and for me to be able to represent America and make it proud is something that means a lot to me, which is really cool. The competition was pretty good, so it was a little bit tricky because we're at like 8,000 elevation, or even, I think we were more.
Uh-huh.
Everyone was just dying. We couldn't breathe, so I wanted to push real hard, and moto helps a lot for that because you're out in the heat, especially here, and it kind of translates to elevation in a way.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I cross-trained on the moto a lot before, and then just pushed hard, and it felt really good, actually.
So KTM, 150 or 125?
150. Yes.
You've always been on two strokes, as I've known you.
Yeah, I like it because it actually crosses over to a mountain bike. I feel more close than a four stroke.
Do you think motocross helps your mountain biking?
For sure.
You think?
Definitely.
Dude, I don't feel that because it's like hard for me to trust a 2-inch wide tire. You know?
I don't know. When I ride this. this thing, it feels like it's just bigger and it feels like I have more control. Mm-hmm. So when I get on a little bike, it just feels like natural.
Yeah.
But it helps for me, it helps me read speed, make decisions faster, like split second decisions that can make or break a situation, and then feel more confident like going bigger. That's the biggest difference I notice. Me compared to a lot of the other girls on my circuit don't like to jump.
Yeah.
I love jumping because of that thing.
Oh yeah.
So that actually helps me a lot in my ranking and where I end up, because there could be a jump that makes or breaks your time or race, and I'll hit it but the other girls will roll it. And yeah, I think that thing a lot, especially arm pump too. Like all the tracks we're just doing this, like a ton of bumps, like the last track in Italy in Val di Sole, feel like you're doing like 100 push-ups and you got to the bottom.
Yeah.
And everyone is complaining, like arm pump was so gnarly. I got to the bottom and it was just like I just got off the dirt bike track.
Yeah.
Like it wasn't that bad, but everyone else was dying, so.
So are people in mountain biking kind of tripping out that your first race was under 2 years ago?
Kind of a little bit. People that come from, I guess, a talented background of motorsports end up in that way. Like I have a friend, his name is Dakota Norton. He's hasn't been racing for very long, maybe 4 or 5 years, and he's already in the elite top 10 at World Cup class. So he grew up racing moto just like me. So I think it transitions over heavily.
Cool.
Yeah, well, I love it.
We need to see you back out of the Swapmoto race.
Yeah, I know. We gotta come back.
Back to
we
the
gotta
roots.
Come back.
Ugly helmet. You better do me right.
Man, I'm always doing
no,
you right.
No, no, you better have some things to say. Not
man,
yes.
I got
last
a lot
time,
to say.
Last time, pal would say something, like 15 sentences, and you go, yes.
No, I'm ready today. Huh? I really like this.
All right, and don't talk like a white newscaster, all right?
All right.
Talk like yourself.
Okay.
All right, say finna. Say fixin'.
Man.
Say man.
I'm going to ask too, hey, can I ride this tomorrow?
What do you think?
Check. Oh, you ain't going to that thing, huh? Ain't them your friends though, for Maximo?
Yeah, they don't support us no more.
What?
Yeah.
Oh, they still be cool with me.
Oh yeah.
Oh shit.
Oh no, I'm going to say Fairmont.
Oh,
I asked
him to.
Stop on
the line,
baby.
Yeah. Man. He talks like a weatherman, huh?
Yeah. His ISO goes up 200 when we go to Zoid.
RV's new sprinter. Hey man, is there some shady deals going on in here?
Yeah, some bullshit's coming on in here.
Huh? Is he trying to sell you some shit?
No, I'm just trying to enjoy this AC you got.
Oh, there is AC.
And wait, you want to see something? Look.
What? This is Adam Campbell's photo
studio.
Can you Photoshop it right here to make that donut go away?
I can do like this. Yeah, I can do one of these things.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, I can
you can do the clone stamp like this. Yeah, man, don't take a picture of a picture.
Is that copyright infringement? I think that's copyright thing. I'm not sure. I have to look into that.
Hey, right now, right? Hey, Scrubby. Do you know that Adam here, we've been friends since he was like 10? Was it 10 or is it older?
Yeah, at least 10.
10?
And then I just thought about it yesterday. We did that, didn't we do, was the run we did, was that in
Rose Bowl?
The Rose Bowl.
Yeah,
was it on the whole thing?
We did a 5K at the Rose Bowl.
Dang, so you've been on him that long for real.
We're talking Indian Dunes.
Yeah.
Three-wheeler days.
Three-wheeler.
That's crazy.
You know, Don, I saw you recently got tagged in one of the that company that's making the three wheelers out of the new 450s.
Yeah, yeah.
I think we should make a comeback. Let's bring it back. I mean, I'll do it if you do it.
I'll do it only if you put the fuzzy side of the Velcro on your side fenders again.
Oh, Jesus. You remember that?
I remember that.
I don't know why my, you know what? I think my dad did the fuzzy Velcro on the sides because he didn't want to scratch the fenders.
That's what it was. He said you didn't want the fenders to get scratched.
Yeah. And meanwhile, mud awesome just sucks to it even more. Right here.
I thought because you played so much, I didn't know this was a real story.
Yeah. Oh, no, this is real.
No, we're old school homies.
Dude, old school.
For sure.
And y'all stayed in touch.
Yeah, we both didn't kind of found the industry, sort of. Yeah.
Hey, you know what's funny? Days. You know what's funny on the GoPro? When you smile, like, all I can see is your teeth. All I can see is your teeth.
How do I get out of here?
Dude, you're trapped now, man.
Hey, tell me about those shoes.
You like those?
Yeah. Well, you call them? Are those On shoes or OC shoes or?
I don't know.
Or QU shoes?
They're just the new height. I just try to follow the trends.
Yeah.
Stay looking good.
But when you're a vet rider, you gotta like pay attention to the trends, right?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
So what are they? Runners? Are they trail runners?
No, these are just casual. My casuals, you know, like if you went to Disneyland with the kids or walking the pits back and forth.
I see them only sold in like Orange County and Tiki shows.
Yeah. Well, you know, you come to the other side, Don. The weather's nicer. Small down by us.
Yeah, that's true.
There's 72 ships out in the water, but yeah.
So how were the laps you took my GoPro for?
They were so-so. I haven't rode in, actually since Loretta's, and I haven't rode a 250 in a while.
Yeah.
But it was good. Bike was good. Track could have been a little better.
Just throw any extra clutches?
No, I don't abuse the clutches.
No?
No.
What?
Ask if he shaves his butthole area.
You shave your butt crack?
Me personally, I do not. Personally, I do not.
That's
it's
awesome.
A pizza. It's just a pizza.
Poor Kristen, huh?
Oh, poor Kristen.
It's the Ocotillo edition.
Put the whip on the back of the fender.
Yeah. All right, so we put a pipe on the YZ250. It's chrome.
Yeah.
Looks like you're going to the dunes.
I think the chrome adds 2 horsepower. So
yeah. How does it make the bike feel?
It feels good. For sure, more bottom end. A little bit crispy off the bottom. And I feel a little bit more over rev. Not as much. But I think it's more noticeable down low. And it sounds way cooler. So.
Yeah, it sounds a lot better, huh?
Yeah.
I just wish it wasn't chrome.
Yeah. It's a bling factor. It's a Zoid edition.
Yeah. How'd you get the boots? How'd you get those Lakers boots?
Hey, limited edition. Hey, you know where I got them at?
Where?
It's only one place in the country that got them.
Where?
Bob Cycle in Washington.
They were selling them?
I got a plug over there.
Well, you know what?
They only made those for him, but
Garnet hit me up and they was going to give the knees and the green ones. Hey, he's flapping his lips.
Yeah, hey. Support riders only. Hey, you know why I got these though? My boy, he had a plug with them. Because they only had made them for him.
Those for Malcolm?
Plug Loom.
Oh, yeah.
Loom plugged in with Malcolm and them. That's the only way I was able to get them.
I was going
to
get them, but I didn't have nothing purple.
I got the whole set.
What, man? Oh, dang. Hey, do you know about that gear you're wearing?
What?
Do you know about the gear you're wearing right now?
No, I'm gonna find out.
No,
hey, actually, I just switched over.
Actually, wait.
I was a Honda rider.
All right, move your goggles for see.
I was a Honda rider. Yeah.
You got logos on it. Can't see. But it says anal on it.
Yeah.
No, it's anal.
Huh?
Anal.
Oh yeah? I am. I'm pretty anal. That
helmet.
Chase, what are your mid-moto snacks typically? Like Cliff Bar?
Usually a Cliff Bar and Nature's Bakery Bar.
Yeah.
Yeah. I've seen some odd things though, like gummy bears.
Man to him, and he gave him like the bro thing like 6 times. Like, I was sitting there like filming it, and it was just.
Let's see
that. Hey, what happened with his brake?
That's fast fuel.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
I told him I have brake.
I'm just the subject of today's vlog. Or what?
Yeah, well, Chase and I went to Charlie Brown Farms the other day.
Uh-huh.
Have you ever been there? They have everything there.
I'm jealous.
They have tri-tip sandwiches, roasted nuts, dinosaur statues, but they also have these.
Oh, yes.
Hell yeah! Raphael.
Hey, I still have.
Yeah, that's our guy, Raphael. Benny's middle name is Raphael, so if you know him,
it's my first name.
Don't address him by anything except Raphael from now on.
Snow Summit reopened after the fire's closure here with Emter, Mattia, Chewbacca with a tank top over there. Feels like we haven't been here in like months.
Feels like forever.
How long has it been? Before Whistler.
Before Whistler, so over a month.
If they could get down Snow Valley too, I think.
Rusty.
Yeah. I haven't been on this bike in so long, it feels weird.
Yeah.
Ready?
Ready.
forgot we're at altitude. I forgot we're at a little bit of altitude. I'm shot.
It smokes you. Air's so dry.
Oh, fuck. Dude, did you see that?
Holy shit, dude. You just gave me a fucking
heart. Oh, fuck. I guess I veered in too much.
Holy shit, dude.
Well, after that near-death experience, I think it was smart to call it a day. Call it a week. Another fun week on two wheels. See what Monday has to bring.